Hey, man, hey, man, we live. All right, man, first and foremost, we're going to say all praise be to Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushai, Hashem, Rekah, Kadash. Double honors to the apostles and elders, the great millstone, Shalom to the sincere, you know, elect, teaching this truth and faith and sincerity through the spirit and power of Yahweh, Hashem, Yahushai, man. And, hey, man, and it's like, you know, as we're in this place, man, you know, get our job, 9:24, Proverbs 29:16. This kingdom has been given on the power and vibration of Esau. And we can't ignore that the scripture calls Esau the people and border of wickedness, man. So under their rulership, it flourishes, you know. And one spirit that flourishes, you know, heavily out there is that transgender spirit. Right, that homosexual spirit, that bestiality spirit, that pedophile spirit, yeah. You know, and the spiritual also, you get that in the Maccabees, you know, they're all free, they're sort of boyfriend, harlot, mm-hmm. and so on and so forth, because look, like, even in Solomon's time, when he actually ruled for like a period of time, our people were keeping the law to the best of their ability, like in order and so on and so forth. But in Esau's reign, right, he just pushes forth all manner of wickedness and it flourishes. Sure. When we rule in the kingdom of heaven, we're actually going to judge this whole earth by the actual law. Esau's got power now and he's totally transgressing it and doing things that are great, man, right?
Like you said something?
Yep.
Can I grab this from Ezra 6:28? Says, as for faith, it shall flourish. Corruption shall be overcome, and the truth which hath been so long without fruit shall be declared. Because he said, right now, Esau does wickedness, and that wickedness flourishes. Right? But, you know, faith is going to come a time when faith is going to flourish. Right? And in the kingdom of Israel, everything going to be, you know, done righteously and in accordance with the scriptures, and the scriptures are life.
Yeah, that's right, man. That's right, man. You know, have you got Job?
Yeah,
you know, got Job?
Job chapter 9 and verse 24, and it reads, the earth is given into the hand of the wicked.
Mm-hmm.
He covereth the faces of the judges thereof.
Mm-hmm.
If not, where and who is he?
So if this man isn't the people of wickedness, who is it? Right? Because the scripture says, ye shall know a tree by his fruits, right?
Mm-hmm.
Now, observe Esau, like, the actual first transgender surgery, I believe, was in 1952 or 1955 in the States of America, man.
Yeah,
that was
yeah.
the first transgender surgery, right? And it's spiritual, because the scripture calls it spiritual Sodom and Egypt, right?
Mm.
And the scripture says they have power over the kings of the earth, because their vibration goes throughout the earth, man. So it started, you know, that whole LGBT stuff, it started over there, and it spread out for the whole planet, man. Right? That's why it's going to cause it the mother of harlots and abominations in the earth, man. Because that country brings forth wickedness right the four corners.
Yeah, and that's why Habakkuk speaks on a warning to them that give thy neighbor drink. Habakkuk, second chapter, and that drink is talking about philosophies, and as the Bible was going into. Right, but that philosophy is, you know, that homosexual agenda, that transgender agenda.
Have
right.
a quick precept. Jeremiah 51:7, Babylon have been holding a cup in the Lord's hand that made all the earth drunken.
Mm.
The nations are drunken of her wine, therefore the nations are mad.
Mm.
You know, so that's going into, you know, Babylon nations, man. You know, into doing their wickedness, man. Like in Dubai, you got a lot of transsexuals. In Brazil, you got an abundance of transsexuals.
Okay.
Trans, you know, so that Babylon juice has gone throughout the four corners of the earth, man, and influenced the masses of the peoples, man.
I've got a precept, bro. This is Revelation chapter 14, verse 8. And there followed another angel, saying, Babylon is fallen, that great city, because she made all nations drink of the wine of the wrath of her fornication. You know, and part of that we're talking about, what part of that wine, that philosophy, is transgender agenda, man.
Yeah.
Okay. You've got a transgender agenda, and then you've got same-sex couples and marriage and all that. You know, that's completely against the scriptures, man. Okay, and the Lord has given examples, like, for example, Sodom and Gomorrah, where it was destroyed because because of going against the law, statutes, and commandments of the Lord, man, for doing that wickedness. And they're doing that till today, man, because the wicked are in rulership. Mm. And America is one of the main, you know, it's Babylon, it's one of the main forefronters of pushing that wickedness on the earth, man, that way.
But let me get you. What was going, Ethan?
Yeah. Right. This is Proverbs 29 and verse 16.
Yes, reconnected. Reconnected. It's live now again.
It's live. Yeah.
It's live now.
Right, let me kill it and refresh. Boom.
Yeah. It says.
Yeah, it's good now. We good now. Yeah, it's good now. We good now. We back.
Is it better? Yeah, it's better.
Yeah.
Alright, cool, man. Yeah. Go ahead.
Yeah, it's a lot of stored for bearing with us. Stored for bearing with us. Right, so I'll just read that again. It's Habakkuk 2:15. Warns him that giveth his neighbor drink. Right, that drink is philosophies that put us down to him and makes them drunken also. Right, and that's the thing with Esau. He wants to make you have his philosophies, man. As opposed to Gubar has been saying, you know, it's almost as if being a heterosexual man is frowned on these days, man.
Yeah.
What's that scripture, Peter's? A lot vexed with a fruitful conversation. Can someone read that after? Go ahead,
Paul. Yeah, so you get it nowadays, man. You might see two lesbians kiss or whatever, and then people that are around you are like, yeah, and you understand. Man, that's fucked. It's just disgusting. Or you might be around women, these faggot neighbors. That's what these women are. Right, but it's okay, he's gay, and they're looking at you sideways for being mad. Right, what's the thing in Esau's kingdom? A man with a beard. Ugh, look at him, you look scruffy. A man who exerts his voice in a loud way, you know, not in like just being a nigger, but you know, we're men. Right? Men have loud voices. You do that, it's a problem. Right, you pull out your bass, it's a problem. Right, you're manly with you know, with, what is it, toxic masculinity. Well, you actually got a term, toxic masculinity.
Explain that, what
that means. Oh, no one knows what the fuck
I
that
don't
means.
Know what that
basically, you Esau wants everyone to be a beta male, man.
Yeah.
And then you get these stupid uni students, right, who hear toxic masculinity, right, because they've been fucking, because they know they're a beta male, right, then they'll run with, oh, you know, these all this toxic masculinity on campus. Just grow a pair, man. Go to the gym.
But that's why. Esau, like, a problem by just creating a term for something.
Yeah.
That doesn't exist.
But what can say? What's America known as in the scripture? Babylon. What's Babylon? Babel, right, meaning confusion, and Lon meaning land, the land of confusion. And toxic masculinity, and that's confusion, man.
Yeah.
Because none of them can even tell you what that is.
Yeah, because Esau tries to pick. Male energy is basically aggressive and harming, you know, so women be afraid.
Yeah.
You know, if you talk to your woman a certain way with an authoritative voice, that means you're
born. Yeah, it's for the spread, you know.
That's what they do. That's why when you go to certain doctor's appointments with your woman and that, you see on the wall they have posters. The posters will say, you know, don't take this if he's doing this to you. That means you're being harassed. You should call his helpline.
So I'm saying about
if your man is telling you what to wear, they actually say that bullet point. If your man is doing any of these things, that means you need to call this helpline and get it sorted out.
See?
And the one bullet point is if he's making you, you know, control what you wear, that means you're being psychologically bullied.
See? See how much of a devil Esau is?
Kind
of. Esau creates a problem, man.
Well, there is, man.
There is,
that's really him against the scriptures, going against the order.
Yep.
The order that the Most High would itself, that women are really men, man.
They're fucking children, man.
God.
It's all like, it's just an ounce of abuse. You tell your 2 year old to put, your 3 year old or whatever, to put a jacket on because it's cold.
Oh yeah, it's abuse, man.
No, I'm saying that's likened to what it is.
Yeah.
Because you see grown ass women, it's cold outside, then you tell them, oh, put your jacket on, wear something more proper. Then when they get ill, they want to come and moan to you.
Well, you had a video that came out the other day. This guy went to his child's school, basically telling the teacher, let my son put on female clothing, because that's what the teacher was doing, making the boys wear girls' clothes and vice versa. So he had to go to the school and complain, man. But then he might get done for that.
Yeah, I was thinking.
You know, he might actually get done for that. That's the kind of society that we're living in now, man. You can't even come against those things.
Because actual teacher, look, If you ask a 3-year-old child what she wants to be, you say a fire truck.
Yeah.
Right?
A dinosaur.
A dinosaur.
Spider-Man.
So if you ask him, yo, do you like this dress? Yeah. You know? And has your parents told you to not wear this dress? Yeah. Do you want to wear the dress? Yeah.
Then you should wear the dress.
From this number. Then, look, you know, I've had the opportunities to work in primary schools, and from outside the classes on the wall,
yeah.
It says, call, big line, is your parent doing anything to you? Yeah. Call this number.
Yeah.
So, a fucking kid might get grounded for his Xbox.
Yeah.
I have a preset. Quick. Okay. Yeah, a kid get his room locked, his PS4 taken away,
yeah.
and the kid comes to school. No, daddy locked me in the room. And that's it.
That's it. You're
done. I have a preset. Finished and you're done.
Yeah. Psalm 58:3. Wicked are strained from the womb. They go astray as soon as they be born, speaking lies.
Mm.
The poison is like the poison of a serpent. They are like the death adder that stoppeth. Her ear, right? So, what is their poison, man? Their gender, their philosophy, right? It's poison, man, because it's a poison as a serpent. Because certain types of serpents here are patient and sly, bro.
Mm-hmm.
And when they then look harmless, for example, there's a serpent that can camouflage as a stick. So you might see it, it's a harmless stick. You go pick up the stick and you get bitten.
Yeah.
That's the spirit of Esau, man.
Okay.
Right? He's patient and crafty, man. Oh, and then eventually, he'll bite you. That's why the scripture says, can a man pity a snake charmer?
Yeah,
you know?
Esau chapter, really.
Oh, you can bring it out if you want.
It's Sirach 12, I'm going to start from verse 10. It says, never trust thine enemy, for like iron rusted, so is his wickedness.
Oh, yeah, and that iron, look, man, iron, you know when it starts to rust like me, because I personally come from an environment work where I see it every day. You actually might see like fresh pieces of iron where it looks silver, then a day later, it's covered in rust.
Yeah.
And when something starts to rust, it won't just stop rusting.
Mm.
You can paint over it at all.
Yeah.
It's going to rust till it gets worse. And then eventually, over time, it consumes. It gets a bit brittle.
Oh, it consumes itself. Yeah, the scripture say about, you know, doing evil, man. When you're doing evil, wronging your own soul, man.
Yeah.
Right?
I've got a quick scripture.
Okay.
2 Esdras chapter 7, verse 20. For there be many that perish in this land because they despise the law of Yahweh that is set before them.
Mm-hmm.
So when you despise the laws of Yahweh Hashem Yahshua, you perish, man. Because what's the latter end of sin? Death, man. That's why America's going to go out with a bang, you know, for all these evil deeds that they've done throughout the four corners of the earth, man. You know, it's primarily, you know,
yeah.
We're counting Sodom and Gomorrah, you know, because they got the spirit of Sodom and Gomorrah in America, man.
I got more on this, come on, sure. Because, yeah, what the Bible is going into, right, about the iron, right, that's physics, you know, iron will rust, and that's what it's saying about Esau and his wickedness, you know, that evil will come out. And that's why I was meditating, if I could segue into this real quick, I was meditating on the fact that we're lucky that, you know, we can, you know, through the spirit, see what, you know, whether guys are Edomite, heathen, whatever, because as soon as you know that, right, you're certain, you're sure of it, right, then you know how to deal with that individual, man. You might be working around an Edomite, but you know, nah, this guy's an Edomite. So I know there's only so far, like, that I can, would you quote unquote, trust this guy, right? You already know how to deal with the guy. You know his nature. You know him better than he knows himself.
Yeah, with these Edomites, like your workplace, whatever, how you deal with them, you got to deal with them like our forefathers. Our father Jacob dealt with Esau, man.
Yeah.
And Jacob kissed Esau's neck.
Yeah.
But he was supplying them, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
You know? So you might be in situations with these guys, but you gotta trust them.
Mm.
I was gonna say, you know, you gotta work with these people, you gotta be around these people if you have to, but you've always remember that's the devil. that's actually the serpent. They're, it's in their spirit to deceive you. They have an enmity against you.
Exactly.
You know?
That's why it's good to say you have to also be wise as a serpent, but harmless as a dove. See, to know a serpent, you got to be like a serpent to an extent. You got to know how it works. You know, he ain't going to fulfill his wicked deeds, but you got to know how it works so you can know how to properly, you know, evade around him.
Yeah, as Postal Bar's been going into in a number of his recent videos, was the different animals. Right, and the top animals, the serpent, dragon, man.
God.
Right? Because that's the highest levels of wisdom that you've got.
Yeah.
Right, when you're able to discern things, you know a man, right? But let me continue. It says, though he humble, verse 11, Sirach 12, right? Though he humble himself and go crouching, right? You know, comes all close to you, right? Yeah. It says, yet take good heed and beware of it, right? It says, and thou shalt be unto him as if thou hast what a looking glass, and thou shalt know that his rust hath not been altogether wiped.
Because it's going to get worse. Mm-hmm.
It's like that.
No, go ahead.
It's sort of like you might see a picture of a bitch, right? Or woman. You look at it, it's like, okay. But then you zoom in, okay, so the foundation's covering up that, it's covering up that. You see, it's not as pretty as it looks. And when you actually look closely, you're like, nah, this is just an ugly hole, man.
Well, that's America, man.
Yeah.
That's America. Come on.
Everything's all glitz and glamour.
Mm.
Everything's painted over with a, you know, a nice looking brush.
Yeah.
Everything, you know, supposedly land of the free.
Yeah.
And all that.
Yeah.
But when you actually go there,
yeah.
or when you actually perceive what's going on, the wickedness that is spreading, you see the cracks in the holes.
When you see the picture with a 10 megapixel camera without the Instagram filters on, right? You see all of the acne, right? You see all of the scratch marks, you see that, oh shit, that's actually weave, right? You see all of that shit, man.
But you know what's beautiful about that? So in the world, these guys in the world, they don't see that.
Mm.
But the Lord's open up our mind through the scriptures to take that filter off all this wickedness, man.
Mm.
This is the true filter, man.
Yeah.
You know, when you filter something through the scriptures, that when it's unclean, it shows it, man, because the scriptures are pure.
Yeah, and it's knowledge and understanding in these scriptures. Well, I'll continue. It says, verse 13, who will pity a child that is bitten with a serpent? Right? And that's sort of like, well, who told you to play with a snake, man? Right? You know, I'll mention, because we were speaking on it before, my great aunt, man, I watched her, she died of cancer, man. But my thing was, look, man, you went to Esau, you trusted him, you took his medicine, through the spirit, you know, his brother was, you know, knows a bit about the herbs. So, you know, what can she do? She didn't want to listen to what I had to say, man. She trusted Esau. So she was flirting with the devil, she played with the devil, and the devil bit her, man.
That's it, man. Yeah. Because that's what people do. They run to Esau, you know, anytime they get sick. And obviously, sometimes you've got to run to Esau, certain things. But for the most part, we're supposed to be independent.
Mm.
You're supposed to know, you know, how to treat certain illnesses that you get. You know, you're supposed to know how to deal with certain things, man. Because you can't trust the devil all the time, man.
Yeah.
You know, like what I was saying, they start giving you all kinds of stuff, you know, that's not even helping, that's fucking you up.
I remember I tried taking a picture of the back of the medicine they were giving her. Right, they would you call they flat out stopped me, man. I said, nah, you can't. Right, it says, who will put your charm that is bitten with a serpent or any such as come nigh wild beasts? Right, so one that goeth to a sinner is defiled with him in his sins. Who will pity?
Oh, you see, the Edomites go to safari, leave the window open, hanging out, trying to take pictures. The videos of Edomites going up to lions, and when they get messed, everyone's like, oh, that's awful, man, that's a wild beast. You should
exactly.
Hey, I remember one guy. I was talking to one guy at work, right? And he was telling me, he's Russian, right? And he was telling me, look, man, I don't like being in the sea.
Mm.
And I said to him, oh, yeah, how come and all that? He said, look, man, that place was not designed for us.
Yeah.
He said, the scripture says that. I was like, okay, he's on point. He was like, that ain't designed for that. I ain't got, you know, I said to him, we ain't got fins and scales.
Yeah.
All that, you know, he said, same thing. I don't like being up too high.
Yeah.
Truly, I'm not a bird, you know?
Yeah.
I was thinking, I was like, yeah, he's on point, man.
God.
You know?
God.
Yeah, like a from fucking hunting birds that was lawful, fishing was lawful. We ain't got no business having fucking Atlantis
scuba diving and all that.
Scuba diving,
Cause some I saw something like that as well. It says the seas aren't shark infested. That's where they live.
Infested in the seas.
Exactly. Esau will go to a place and it'll be like, oh, this place has too many mosquitoes or whatever. Let's kill all the mosquitoes.
Yeah.
Think about Esau, right? Wherever he goes, wherever he sees, he always sees you as infestation. Mm. Everyone other than him, everything other than Esau, he sees, he puts the vibration, that's the infestation. You're the infestation.
Yeah, that's right.
You're the only thing the Lord talks about, you know, well, Babylon, and he completely being wiped out, man.
You're the only one not promised any future of salvation.
That's right, man.
You're how does the Zondervan put it? The only neighbor of the Israelites not promised any chance of salvation, man.
That's right.
So there's I mean, that's it on that, man.
I was going through the spirit. I was going through an article on something that would come out recently. I'm just going to read it now in the Forbes magazine. And the title is New Science Suggests Biblical City of Sodom was smoked by an exploding meteor. So that's what Esau was trying to push out there. Okay. Which we know according to the scriptures, which will be that the Lord destroyed it with fire and brimstone. I'm going to read a couple of excerpts of it because they say some interesting things, man. Mm. Now, it says, I'm going to read this. It says, samples from the site show that an extremely hot, explosive event leveled an area of almost 200 square miles. It says, not only wiping out 100%. Of the Middle Bronze Age cities and towns, but also stripping agricultural soils from once fertile fields. And the scripture was it Genesis 19? He even talks about the vegetation.
Yeah.
You know? And I'm just going to read this other article, because I was going through the different articles. Now this one is, on Yahoo News, and it's by the same news. It says, previously, archaeologists have believed that the settlement might have been damaged in an earthquake.
See how much of a faithless prick Esau is, bro.
Right. And then it says, but the damage to the walls is directional, hinting it might be a shockwave. A pottery shard found at the site also had one side melted into glass, which the researchers believe could have been caused by a sudden temperature of 4,000 degrees. Samples from the soil also show high levels of sulfates.
Do you
want to
say something?
Yeah, I was going to say, and that's the difference between an Israelite and more so an Israelite. And this truth is, when we were, for instance, we was told the story of Noah when we were young, of shit, that happened. Hey, that's amazing. God is amazing. Esau, on the other hand, being a faithless dog, episode Psalm 61:6, he has to go out and complete that diligent search, right? For instance, us, man, we don't know how, you know, the intricacies of Noah's Ark, but we have faith. And that's all that we need.
Yeah, and what the Lord will actually do is like show like it. You might go and research it.
Mm-hmm.
You read, like, oh yeah, it kind of boosts the faith.
Mm-hmm. Like
for example, you know the point on sulfur, right? The most potent sulfur on the planet, where it's found is Sodom and Gomorrah, man.
God.
You know, and those still things. Like, I think from the information I stopped were actually was reading that they're saying most sulfur is only like of purity of 40%, right? But in Sodom and Gomorrah, the actual purity of the sulfur is 96%. So that's, and then you know if you actually observe it, it burns so hot that it turns into a liquid and spreads, you know. And that same judgment is going to happen to America. Because remember, I read that like in Revelation 11 and 8. Because remember, the scripture calls it spiritually Sodom and Egypt. Mm-hmm. Right? This is Revelation 11 and 8. And their dead bodies shall lie in the street of the great city, which is spiritually called Sodom and Egypt, where also our Lord is crucified. Now it says spiritually Sodom. Because of what? The transgenderism, the homosexuality, and the things are such that their vibration is pushed forth throughout the earth, right? And guess what? If it's spiritual Sodom, it's going to receive the same judgment as Sodom.
Okay.
It's not going to, yeah, it's just there. It's Sodom, innit? It's not just Sodom, innit? No, it's just going to receive the same judgment as Sodom. And if you go into the word Sodom in the Hebrew, it's Saddam, which means the burning. Right, so that's that was spiritual Norman Norman for that time, and a Norman Norman for this time. You know, and it's like it says spiritual Sodom and Egypt, because guess what? That was a place of captivity for our people, right? That was a place of captivity for our people, and you know, if you go on the money, you know, there's a pyramid on it. Then you even got some fucking towns in America that's named after towns in Egypt.
Yeah.
You know, and guess what? Egypt was taken down too. You know. By the Lord. So the spirit called Sodom and Egypt. Guess what? It's actually going to be taken down too, and they're going to be burned. You know?
Yeah.
That's what's going to happen to America, man.
Can I read a bit more on this point to bring up? It says, which may have meant that the area was left unable to support farming for hundreds of years after the blast, which the researchers say may have been equivalent to a 10 megaton nuclear device.
Yeah.
Now they're, you know, making their speculations. But the thing is, the Lord now, I was looking at nuclear devices, okay? There's that, for example, the Russians made the Tsar bomber, okay? Which had a 50 megaton, five times that, a 50 megaton yield. Now, you got to think about it like this. America, which is Babylon, which is, has been spoken of as Sodom and Gomorrah. And it says that the time that we're going into, a time that never been before, that destruction is going to be, if that happened in Sodom and Gomorrah, we can still see, watch documentaries, and still see articles coming up about it, about how it is today, and they're still researching it. Well, think about America, man. America's going to be made that example. And even a greater destruction, because the Lord's actually given the higher technology to these devils to destroy themselves, man. You know? And it says, what, Satan be divided against Satan. That's right. America and Russia, man. The guy, they're both Edomite nations, man. And ultimately, they're all being pulled into this by the elites. You know?
That's right. I might have 2 Peter's.
Go ahead.
This is 2 Peter chapter 2 and verse 5. And spare not the old world, but save not a person, a creature of righteousness, bringing in a flood upon the world of the ungodly, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example on those that after should live ungodly.
So the Lord destroyed Sodom and Gomorrah. He's like, look, man, don't fuck with me, right? But he said, this is why you don't fuck with me. You don't promote, you know, homosexuality, do all of this weirdness, right? And then just get away with it. No, there are consequences for your actions,
yeah.
Right? But then Esau, you know, being, you know, the what you call it, the proud man that he is, right? He said, whatever, and he's done it anyway. Right, and then for that, America will be destroyed.
That's it,
right? Because you know, certain, like for instance, is whether if a man lays down with the beast, you've got to kill the man and the beast. Right, there comes a point where, what do you call it, there's too many people left to kill. Right, and you gotta do what Abraham did and said, Lord, man, look, if there's any righteous left in the city, you know, save them. And Lord, like, of course, the Lord's gonna save the righteous. But the rest of demons on them, and they need to be destroyed for their own good.
Yeah.
Right? You got Jakes out there right now, man. You speaking about some of the homosexual Jakes you see on that day to day, right? And bro, these Jakes go too through, man. They're through.
Oh, I've got a precept for you. This is Isaiah chapter 3, verse 8. For Jerusalem is ruined, and Judah is fallen, because their tongue and their doings are against the Lord. To provoke the eyes of his glory, the show of their countenance doth witness against them, and they declare their sin as Sodom, they hide it not.
Yeah, well, that's why spiritually Sodom. You know, because here, like, and it's crazy when you think about it. America and its kingdom is more wicked than Sodom and Gomorrah was.
Okay.
It's more wicked. Do you know why? Because in Sodom and Gomorrah, you actually probably had men just wearing a dress, being faggot, you know, being freaks, you know, right? Being freaks, right? Being freaks. being freaks, right? But now, you actually have grown men with clits, with fake pussies now, with fake tits now, you know? With a with like a cup size, like a double
32 D, double D, like, you know?
With a D.
With a D. You can see that.
He's triple D.
Yeah, he's triple D.
Triple D in it.
Yeah. Oh, man. You know? Because back then, you probably had men, you know, probably had padded to look like women. Mm. But now, you actually have them, you know.
Oh, you must have, because that's why the law is there. Man shall not wear that which pertains to a woman.
And if you go into to the law, I believe it's the description, Numbers or whatever, where it's basically said, the law is going to give you his laws so that you don't do as the Egyptians
would do. Yeah. Lineups?
Yeah, the lineups.
Right. Jeremiah 10 and 1, learn not the way of the heathens.
Yeah.
And it says, and it said in the scripture, it said, they declare their sin of Sodom, they hide it not.
No, we don't hide the hair, boy.
Yeah, and they're out there, man.
Oh, it's cool.
They know that we were talking about it earlier. You know, 10 years ago, 20 years ago, you know, guys at school, you know, closet, in the closet, not really out there, on the D low. Like now, man, now you walk around, you know, you go out on the street, man, you've been walking for 20 minutes, you see it, you know,
20 minutes,
bro. It's like
you get on the bus, man.
You know, you see these guys out there, man, these freaks.
you can't say it like that.
Because the posters, they don't say the F word like that, man. Right? So it was probably the example, you know. Hey, we brother said forgot, you know, because they forgot, you know, Sodom and Gomorrah, you know. You know, this is a let me grab this real quick. It says Psalm 64 and 2, hide me from the secret counsel of the wicked, right, from the insurrection of the workers of iniquity. Right, I'm grabbing that because what the brother was talking about back in the day, right, we say you never saw in 5, 6, 7 years ago, Jay weren't, you know, coming out of the closet like they are today, right? But what's Esau been doing, right? You watch Netflix, man, Netflix, and all these TV shows like having a black, quote unquote, black freak, man.
Oh, even the Sabrina the Teenage Witch.
Yeah.
And bros, you got a black guy in there. He's a flamer, man.
Yeah.
Oh, man. But it sounds like the worst program on earth.
Bro, flamer whopper.
He's a serious whopper, man.
Yeah.
Damn, fries.
Yeah. He's a firework.
Yeah. And that's the thing. Scriptures taught. That's why the Lord said he separated us, man. Right, because when Jake is around these heathens, start taking customs of the heathens, right, and then start, and they excel at it, man. They excel at the wickedness. Right, when you see a Jake, which is, for instance, the coffee shop I go to in the morning, man, bro, this Jake, he's a proper freak, man.
You know, you got to just make sure you say freak.
He's like, you know, them singing ones as well.
Oh, wow.
Right? But what was programs like Netflix, got Arrow, all of these programs where the Jake, right, is the only homosexual in the thing, man.
Yeah.
They've
been pushing that hard, man. Yeah. So you got all these, like, in the past year, there's been a new trend of comedians coming out wearing a dress.
Yeah.
Like the actual ultimate, like, epitome of being funny is wearing a dress.
Yeah.
Dave Chappelle's talking about
it. Dave Chappelle.
All his Netflix specials, he's talking about homosexuals, man.
Yeah, he went away for 10 years?
Yeah.
What was that again?
To fucking go and he went to go and hide in Ghana.
Yeah.
Because they won't put him to death.
Yeah.
And he came back and he took that deal again. You know, after he was on his knees, you know.
Yeah, give it, suck it.
He was sucking it, fucking it, and throwing it back.
Yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Hey, he has a joke about that.
Yeah.
Yeah, he says, you know, a guy might come and say, you know, suck a dick and hold a gun to you. That might have been Chris Rock. They're in the same spirit anyway.
Yeah.
He was just like, you know, he just did it, man. He pretended the microphone was a dick and he kissed it and all that. So that's how you know he ain't out there promoting not to do that, man. You can go on YouTube and look at that, man. These guys are, you know, prize, man.
The point of that secret council is the Illuminati, man.
You gotta get out.
Right? That's the Illuminati. People say, oh, it's bubbles, we're not in bubble time. No, it's Illuminati. It's the present-day thing. It's written in the scripture. It's what it is. It's a secret council. Right? And their work is pushing that agenda on Jake in the hope that Jake will lose the birthright, right? So that they can get the birthright because they think it's theirs. But then I'll read Genesis, the 25th chapter, before it says, even in the womb it was prophesied.
Yeah, because these Edomites can't learn righteousness. It says that in Isaiah 25, let favor be shown to the wicked, yet he not they can't do it. Mm. They can't get right. Jeremiah 13:23, can an Ethiopian change his skin or the leopard spots? Then may ye also do good that are accustomed to do evil.
Yeah.
These Edomites, they're wicked.
Yeah.
They actually enjoy it. Like I personally work with one who's like into witchcraft. Mm-hmm. You know, he's done tarot cards, he's seen spirits and stuff, and he's normal, man. I've seen spirits, you know, I've seen dead family members standing in my house. Mm-hmm. I've seen, you know, whatever, and he's cool, man. Mm-hmm. He looks healthy, you know.
Mm-hmm.
But when the Jake gets into when Jake's set up. I'm slipping, falling.
They're the accused of our brethren. Love that. They love to, because you know what? These other nations don't really know, man. This is the enmity between Esau and Jacob, man. They're trying to really, when they love it when Jake is doing, they see Jake and Jake's doing some fucking acting like a jailer, you know, or you know, basically doing something against righteousness. They love that shit, man.
I have a precept. Have you finished on that?
Yeah.
Psalms 12:8. The wicked walk on every side when the vilest men are exalted.
Mm-hmm.
So basically, when the actual most vile people are exalted, the people who push it forth are the people of wickedness. Who's the of wickedness? Get Malachi 1.
Say peace and safety.
Okay.
Yeah. First Thessalonians 5, isn't it? But get Malachi. 1:4, the border of wickedness, because it says the wicked walk on every side where the vilest men are exalted. You know what? I'm gonna do that.
Well, I've got a precept on you.
Go ahead, man. I'm going to word about.
This is Joel chapter 30, and they were meeting verse 8. They were children of fools, yea, children of base men, were viler than the earth. You know, just to back up what the brother's saying. These Edomites are vile, man. They're absolutely vile. They're viler than the earth, it says, man. They were children of fools, children of base men. They're on that lowest level, and they're pushing out of that vibe from the earth. You know?
Yeah. All right, so now if you go into the word vile, it just means the same thing, you know, worthlessness or vileness, you know? So that's basically, you know what, but then, you know, if you go into the word, you know, vile, in terms of the etymology, that could be interesting, because really anything that is vile is just sin. Like, basically, anything that transgresses the actual law is sin, right? Now, the vilest men are what? Men who are into homosexuality, men into pedophilia, into bestiality. Which is wickedness. Mm. Like even the so-called Jews, they say, well, if a man lie for the mankind is wickedness.
Semantics.
So basically, that don't apply to a boy, because the boy is not man yet. That's these people, man.
Wickedness, man.
That's the same as say, well, it says in the right hand or in the forehead. So for taking the left,
the devil.
That's the same guy.
Yeah.
Show me in the scriptures where it says you can circumcise a boy with your mouth, man. You be sucking the blood of a cut foreskin. So he's circumcised, yeah, keeping the law, but you're blowing his rod, man.
It just goes to like, why would that even cross your mind?
Because he's Esau. Esau. It says they can't sleep till they do wickedness, man. Do you know how we go and put out that prayer?
Yeah.
He's just thinking about wickedness.
Yeah.
Man.
Oh,
shit, man. What am I gonna do to
him?
And you said they suck the blood?
Yeah, they.
What's Esau's fascination with that blood, man? That raw bloody meat.
And the thing is, Esau
he's beating that bloody meat and that little boys, man.
Let me grab this real quick. It's Isaiah 10, right? It says, woe unto them that decree unrighteous decrees and that grievousness which they have prescribed, right? Because Esau will want to do wickedness, right? And he want everyone to be down with wickedness. So he'll write a law to, you know, push everyone to do the wickedness that he wants to do himself. Like, he wants to be an out-and-out homosexuality, so he writes laws so that you can be an out-and-out homosexual, right? And then he writes other laws to prevent the discrimination of out and out of homosexuality.
He's the perfect devil.
Yeah.
Hey, sorry to quote in this series. It's a brief.
No, that series bad.
Yeah, because I feel the comment to my head.
Each episode is a video, man.
Do you remember? Yeah.
Well, it's been there. I'm filming. I've seen.
How many episodes you watched?
I've watched 9. So
have you done 9 videos?
Hey, coming soon. It's not, bro. It's
there's a particular scene. I don't know if you remember it, where the demon inside the guy, the uncle. Confesses, the demon confesses that the reason he chose to go into the guy is because he was a homosexual.
Yep.
Because he was an abomination.
Yep.
See?
The demon confessed, that's why he jumped in.
Bo.
They brought it out?
Hey, Sabrina, man, you gotta watch that, man. It's the chilling adventures of Sabrina.
If the spirit's on you to watch it, if you just came in like a month ago, you don't want to be watching.
You don't wanna, because that's
what we're trying to say, also on some super high levels, I'm just saying. You know, just watch the bottom.
He is much higher.
Just to back you up
level.
Leviticus chapter 20, verse 13.
Right?
If a man also lie with a mankind.
And this could even get your page taken down. This is in the scripture.
And this is in the scriptures.
Yeah, the Bible, the King James version
of the Bible that we're reading. We're reading it from the Bible.
You know what? This is. You got
disclaimer. Leviticus 20:13.
Yeah.
If a man also lie with mankind, as he lieth with a woman, right? So how do you lie with a woman?
Intercourse.
Yeah.
Sex.
Both of them have committed an abomination. I just want to say this point. Get these guys to interviews in prison.
Yeah. I ain't gay. You know.
I was on top. Yeah. You know how they say that?
Yeah.
Well, look what the scriptures say. The scriptures say both of them have committed an abomination. They shall surely be put to death, their blood shall be upon them. That's in the law, man.
What does it say?
It says, they shall surely be put to death, their blood shall be upon them.
Now, what's going on in Sodom and Gomorrah? Get the story of the angels trying to pop blood, bro. No, the men trying to pop blood, the angels.
If I can just to double back on what the brother said, you know, on that disclaimer, because there are certain points in that thing, in that, you know, because there's certain statements made where if you haven't got an understanding of the scriptures, you might actually bug out. Disclaimer.
You know, just watch it.
This brother said,
I should watch it. Bro, he does a video on you.
No,
because they call the Most High a false god in that show, man.
They did.
Bro, so if you ain't grounded, man, and that's the light thing, man.
Shit.
That's light in the show.
Oh, man, I got to watch this.
Right. It's hell, Satan, Prince Satan. Like, how we say, look, for one of the y'all watching, man,
the
whole show, they're doing that.
Yep, it is even the same way they invite Baphomet to the yard, right, for dinner, right? You know, Baphomet takes on human form, right, comes to the house for dinner, right, and the auntie's like, look, man, I made your favorite roast chow.
Oh, but they were reenacting Cain and Abel in that scene.
Yeah.
Then she got jealous because they didn't like her food.
Yeah.
He liked the sister's food.
Yeah.
They split the whole thing around, bro.
She killed the sister and she says, I'm my sister's keeper.
Yeah, she said, I'm my sister's keeper. Bro, it's not working.
He's on the world. But let's jump into this, bro.
Yeah.
Jump into this,
bro. This is Genesis chapter 19, and I'll start from 5.
That's crazy.
But before they lay down, the men of the city, even the men of Sodom, compassed the house.
Start from one so we can give a background.
All right. This is from the top, Genesis chapter 19. And there came two angels to Sodom at even, and Lot sat in the gate of Sodom. And Lot, seeing them, rose up to meet them, and he bowed himself with his face toward the ground. And he said, behold, now, my lords, turn in, I pray you, and into your servant's house, and tarry all night, and wash your feet, and you shall rise up early and go on your ways.
Yeah, so he basically saw two angels that came to form of men, you know?
And they said, nay, but we will abide in the street all night. And he pressed upon them greatly, and they turned in unto him, and entered into his house, and he made them a feast, and did bake unleavened bread, and they did eat. But before they lay down, the men of the city, even the men of Sodom, compassed the house round, both old and young.
So, now, you actually got to put that into perspective, man. So, compass means what, to go around, man. So he had old men, you know, he's more wrinkly, young, stripling, you know, you know, quick, right? Outside the house, just surrounded from every quarter. Yeah, man, so I'm coming from Peckham, I'm from Brixton, right? Yo, and it spread quick,
yeah.
You know? So that was, you know, before social media, that, yo, man, if you see these guys, now go ahead. Mm.
All the people from every quarter, and they called unto Lot and said unto him,
oh, now, you know what's spiritual, though? You know what's spiritual about this story? Now, actually, if you keep going, I'm going to make the point after this point.
Where are the men which came in unto thee this night?
Where they at, man? You know?
Yeah.
Go ahead.
Bring them out unto us that we may know them.
Straight up. They weren't beating around the bush.
Yeah.
They said, look, them guys we saw, look, we saw them, man. Bring them out so we can fuck them. That's what they said.
Yeah.
That's what they said. They said, you can hear? Yeah. He said, bring them out so that we can fuck them, right? Now, what was interesting about that statement is this, right? The whole culture and society was into that wickedness. It wasn't in no clip. That's the same spirit now. Like that same spirit here, it's like it's normal to be a freak.
Yeah.
It's normal to be an abomination.
God.
Go ahead.
Isaiah 3:9. Show up the countenance, doth witness against
them. Spirit's coming out again.
And they declare their sin and Sodom, they hide it not. Woe unto their soul, for they have rewarded evil unto themselves.
Woe unto their soul, as the scripture says, their blood shall be upon them. Yeah, for example. But they did destroy your own soul, man.
Yeah.
Right, so what does the scripture say? Rough paraphrasing. Right, he that hateth me loves death, and loving is
keeping the law. So, yeah. So hating is not keeping the law.
That's right.
You know. So really, that's a hate.
Yeah.
So that's a real hate crime.
See
how the spirit. Mm. It's like we ain't gonna do it. But let's say we were to like enforce the scriptures in this society, it would be considered a hate crime.
Yeah.
But really, not enforcing the scriptures is a hate crime.
Yeah,
that's a hate.
Yeah.
Hate shit.
Yeah, babe, because why when these things, when the law when the judgment was meet for this crime, what would you do? You do it in front of all of Israel.
So obviously
would fit. And so what? You bring your son and you make sure that your son watches, right? So that he doesn't get any ideas.
Like, for example, according unto the law, if he blasphemed the name of the Lord, yeah, if somebody blasphemes and you hear them, you have to report it instantly and get judged.
Because
if you don't put them to death, you're in danger of being judged too. Because if you don't cut out his spirit, it'll spread among the people. Yeah.
Yep. Which is what happened with this homosexuality.
The LGBT.
Spread amongst the people.
From America.
Yeah.
Now you've got fucking Iran. The Islamic Republic, brother. Yes. Of Iran, right? You know, all the high and mighty stuff. Iran, brother. It's the
destroy third. America, brother.
They said that, right? All of that stuff, right? Now, they have third most transgender surgeries on earth. But see what I'm saying? Before it started in that little bubble, not that bubble, but America. Now it's progressed. And really, like, that homosexual agenda has really kicked off since what? The 60s from that whole rise of feminism, you know, being free, that free spirit.
Oh.
That whole vibration of free spirit is a demon.
Yeah.
Because it's anytime you actually meet a girl, into that free spirit culture and feminism.
Yeah.
They're fucking epitome of being a feminist is being a dick with the shirt off.
Yeah,
yeah.
Satanist, really.
Yeah, you which is show you Sabrina as well. Show you that in Sabrina as well.
Man, those are. One time I was fucking. I saw a site where you know them sites where you can kind of see chicks or whatever, right? Yeah. And I saw a fucking dyke. You know how us brothers might go to the beach and take a picture of the beach with your top off, you know, all in the sun. See a dyke with tats taking a picture with her top off in the sun on the beach, just running around like as a man. But really,
demons.
That's a demon. That's a demon, bro. That's not righteous. But this world uplifts that wickedness. And that was going on in Sodom and Gomorrah. It was so casual to be you know, into men and men work with men and women work with women. Go ahead.
And it says that we may know them.
Which means have sex.
Because the guy might get simple and say, oh, you know, but it's going to be able to explain it.
Yeah, yeah.
It says, and Lot went out at the door unto them, shut the door after him, and said, I pray you, brethren, do not so wickedly. Right, so what if he just wants to just have a chat with them, get to know them? Why is that wicked? Right, and it goes on to say, behold, now I have two daughters which have not known man.
If I can say that, just shows you the worth of a woman.
Mm.
That shows you the worth of a woman, because he was like, look, man, he was a virgin daughters. That was money, you know. He was gonna put the dowry for them women, man.
Yeah.
Right, but he was like, look, man, all right, man, hey, don't do wicked. Me, man, yo, just have my daughters instead.
They didn't even want
it. He did, you know.
Let me, I pray you, bring them out unto you, and do you eat to them as is good in your eyes. Only unto these men do nothing, for therefore came they under the shadow of my roof.
So he basically was willing to sacrifice his daughters,
because
he said, do as is good in your eyes. Everybody would have put them and killed them.
Yeah, like in Judges 19.
Yeah, can't. So that was really, he was willing to sacrifice.
And also in the law that when, you know, someone's in your household, can you protect them, you know?
Yep, that's right.
And it says, and they said, stand back. And they said, again, this one fellow came into sojourn, and he will needs be a judge now. We will deal worse with thee than with them. And they pressed sore upon the man, even Lot, and came near to break the door. But the men...
No, wait, what? Hold on. Like, you know how, like, a police might go to someone's house and kick the door down?
Mm.
That's what they were doing. They're like, look, man, you better open that door, you know? Yeah. Man's banging down with zeal. He's banging it down with zeal. he's banging the door down with zeal, bro.
Trying to kick the door in there.
Kicking the door,
you know,
in.
That nigga kick on the
door. Boom, you know. Hold me, you know.
Yeah.
Don't get him down, man. Don't get him down. Because guess what? They were so engulfed in that spirit of wickedness. That demon was on them. So they was down.
Yeah,
yeah. And that's what happens in this kingdom.
Mm-hmm.
In this kingdom, if you ain't into that sort of stuff, right? If you do that sort of stuff, people, it's like people back you up.
Yeah.
Like, I remember one time I was talking to one fucking from some chick, man, from like Colombia or whatever. I was talking to her and she was like for like a couple of days it was all cool, blessed, we were vibing, right? And then she asked me my opinion on homosexuality. I said, personally, I'm not really into that. And I just left it as that.
Mm.
This started to back me up. Where? What's up?
Yeah. That's what, slut. Hey, slut. Homosexual.
Enablers.
Let's call them enablers.
You got a creamy in your channel.
Hey, it's slut. You know, hey, what is a serpent, you know?
Yeah, you know.
Enablers.
That's right, you know? So anyway, man. Like, she ended up not talking to me anymore because she was backing me up because I was down with them sort of people.
Yeah. And that's the thing, and that's why Esau, you gotta give Esau a hand, man, right? Because Esau was the perfect devil. Because what did he do? Right, he basically made it so that these bitches put the vagina on lock, right? So then he based, and then he made men beta males. He made the men simps, right? So the men just end up doing whatever they have to do, right, to get the box. And then what did he give the women? He gave the women that homosexuality, and then said, hey, push that shit. So a normal situation, right? You know this. You know, if you want to say to a brother, right, what's your opinion? And as soon as he saw that he might lose the box, oh well, you know, it's okay. Right, then all of a sudden, man starts flippy-flipping. And then before you know it, man's going with his missus to Pride, man. Because his missus, oh, but I like this, there's nothing wrong. He doesn't want to be it, but his missus is going, he doesn't want to lose the box.
All up in the midst of the carnival, yeah. The crowd.
Yeah, and then he's all there, you know what, I had a lot of fun today. And all of that, all of a sudden, he's cool with it. Where did it come from? It came from Esau being the devil, right, and then working with the woman, man.
That then hurt, and that also proves it's a demon. You know why? Because you have Jake from the ends. Don't go to school, uni, whatever. Mm. Jake end up going uni, man.
Yeah.
Like, yeah, man, it's not even that. Not, yeah. I ain't got a problem with that.
My eyes are open now, you know. Think outside the box.
Yeah.
No, I'm trying to think in the box, man.
Yeah.
That's it. I'm trying to think. That is the chariot.
I'm trying to think in the box of the scriptures, man.
Exactly.
I'm trying to think outside this box.
Yeah.
You know, and I'm trying to think outside the Sophia box.
That's right.
Yeah, that's right.
I'm
trying to get down with Sophia.
That's right. If I can, and that's why the scriptures say, if you've got wickedness, you've got to take it out, man. Because what probably happened with them Drakes is there was at the uni, shared class with the homosexual. The homosexual was cool or whatever. Mm-hmm. And then it was like, you know what? It's not too bad, these homosexuals, man.
Mm-hmm.
And that's how it spreads. Then you know, then you ain't got no voices against it. Then you're like, you know, homosexual ain't that bad. Man has a homosexual episode.
Yeah.
Episode.
Hey, and that's why in the scriptures, in the book of the Bible, there's certain transgressions that are punished with death.
Yeah.
So like, it doesn't spread.
You can't eat that cancer, done.
Can't. Yeah. It has to be nipped in the bud, man. So, the contamination doesn't go as far. You know?
That's right.
I was going to jump down to the 24.
Nah.
Can you read it?
Keep reading for it. Speak for it.
Cool. But the men put forth their hand, called Lot into the house to them, and shut to the door. And they smote the men that were at the door of the house with blindness, both small and great, so that they wearied themselves to find the door.
So, like, even in their blind state, they were still trying to find the door to go and pop the men. So them guys be blind, pulling out their rod.
That's that burning loss.
That burning loss, and that vibration's out here.
Yeah.
Go ahead.
And the men stood down to Lot. Has thou here any besides?
See, you know how wicked this place is. Yeah? This place is so wicked. They have a LGBTQ parade.
Mm-hmm.
Now, I swear, I'm sure it's LGBTQ plus. It's like
plus, yeah.
Every year they add another fucking something.
It's because people, it's confusion, it's a mess.
A lot of them don't like each other.
Yeah.
Yeah, a lot of them don't like each other. And I was watching a documentary on the NAMBLA, North American Manboy Love Association. I was watching the actual documentary of them. Which if you brothers ain't seen that documentary, that's one of the documentaries I suggest you watch.
Mm.
It basically shows that the Kikei friends out there, you actually have a section of paedophilia.
Mm.
And there was interviewing the homosexual men, right, saying, should paedophilia be that accepted? And then basically, all of them was like, yeah, well, if someone wants to do that, they can do that. And most of them were saying, I was having a relationship with a man when I was about 6 years old. Getting popped out. So a lot of these people who are homosexuals got popped by a man up in age when they were younger, man. So the actual next step that LGBTQ plus is going to be that paedophile, man. Right? Because you know why? I believe a couple of years ago, those people are making paedophilia a sexual orientation.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, you even got what you call paedophile sex dolls, baby sex dolls for paedophiles.
Yeah, man. See, like, okay, I'm a showman. next door, so that he can go and violate the dog. But it's right. It's okay. And he got something in this kingdom called the virtuous pedophiles. You actually got something in this kingdom called the virtuous pedophiles. Basically, men who confess that they like young babies, but they ain't done shit yet.
Oh yeah.
Apparently.
Yeah. Control. They call this like control pedophilia. I remember looking into that, man.
Yeah.
All that, man.
Yeah.
Yeah. They're trying to get rights. They're trying to say, you know, love should be love. Basically, they're trying to, you know, get rights, man.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay. This is pink news. I've heard this before. I believe it's legit news. It says NYC Pride accused of being a celebration of pedophilia for putting a 10-year-old drag kid in campaign. 14th March 2018. What you were speaking on about how they're not even together. The Pride of London organizers sorry for over anti-trans protest in their own thing. British Airways hired convicted paedophile drag queen as part of its gay pride, blah, 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 blah. And, these are stories from this year, man.
That's right. Go on.
All right. And it says, and the men selling to Lot has thou any besides, son-in-law and thy sons and thy daughters, and whatsoever thou hast in the city, bring them out of this place. For we will destroy this place, because thy, the cry them is waxing great before the face of the Lord.
Oh, that's right. Someone hold Revelation 18 because the sins have reached up unto heaven.
Oh, man. So, yeah, that pig news is legit. It's by Benjamin Cohen.
See how the spirit works? It's run by so-called Jews. Mm-hmm. Right? Now, it says, because what? Their cries reach up unto heaven.
Mm-hmm.
That shows what? What does the scripture say in Amos 9. I'm gonna get it. Right? This is Amos 9 and 10. No. And 18, I believe. No, 8. Yeah. Behold, the eyes of the Lord are upon the sinful kingdom, and I will destroy it from the face of the earth. Now, the eyes of the Lord are who, man? His angels. Right, because the word angels means what? Messenger, right? So the angels are his personal like CCTV. Mm-hmm. That's why Esau's really trying to cook up outside, man. You know, he's trying to have CCTV everywhere to see everything, mm-hmm. Right? So because essentially his fucking surveillance is for angels. You know, that's his messengers,
yeah.
Right? But that's the Lord. Or upon a sinful kingdom, which that applies to Jake, but not applies to Esau, and that he will destroy it from the face of the earth, man. Because guess what? The time gonna come where the Heavenly Father gonna say, look, okay, that's it. It's time. You know? Go ahead.
And it says, the cry of them is waxing great before the face of the Lord, and the Lord have sent us to destroy it.
Mm. That's what's gonna happen. And the scripture says basically, hold the four winds until that time.
Yep.
Yeah, Revelation 7.
That's what's going to happen. The time going to come where the Lord, which might be 2009, the Lord might stir up his angels to make it hotter. And one day, that's it.
We've been seeing some good things happening this year, man. We mentioned you've had Caitlyn Bruce Jenner's house get burnt down.
Oh, yeah, in Paradise.
Right? It was a part of the California wildfires. Right, you know, you had a place called Paradise. I mean, come on, Paradise burn.
That's a miracle, bro. That was an omen for a miracle.
You know, we're seeing the chip being pushed. Oh, you had the articles that came out here in the UK about how a major employer in the UK employs hundreds of thousands of people, right? It's looking to, start chipping its employees, man.
Yes, you have the thing in Sweden, that's where the UK is. You know? Go ahead up.
And it says, and Lot went out.
Oh, someone get the Peters for Lot, you know, vexed.
Yeah, good.
And then get Revelation and we'll close out.
And Lot went out and spake unto his sons-in-law, which married his daughters, and said, go up get you out of this place, for the Lord will destroy the city. But he seemed as one that mocked unto his sons in law.
You know, speaking, man?
Yeah, I was just, hey, they were mocking him, man. You know, he was saying, look, like he, the angels told him, look, you want to warn them, your sons in law. But they weren't meant to get it, man. They weren't meant to get it destroyed. You know, that's why they were mocking against the
well, his sons in law. His sons in law didn't mock him.
Oh, okay.
But his daughters, you know, because his daughter, that's his seed, isn't it? So yeah. Lord have mercy on him.
Yeah.
But his wife didn't.
Yeah. And it says, and when the morning arose, then the angels hastened Lot, saying, arise, take thy wife and thy two daughters, which are here, lest thou be consumed in the iniquity of the city. And while he lingered, the men laid hold upon his hand, and upon the hand of his wife, and upon the hand of his two daughters, the Lord being merciful unto him, and they brought him forth and set him without the city. And it came to pass, when they had brought them forth abroad, that he said, escape for thy life. Look not behind thee, neither stay thou in all the plain. Escape to the mountain, lest thou be consumed. And Lot said unto them, O, not so, my Lord. Behold, now thy servant hath found grace in thy sight, and thou hast magnified thy mercy, which thou hast shewed unto me in saving my life. And I cannot escape to the mountain, lest some evil take me and I die. Behold now, this city is near to flee unto, and is a little one. Oh, let me escape thither. Is it not a little one? And my soul shall live. And he said unto him, see, I have accepted thee concerning this thing also, that I will not overthrow this city for the which thou hast spoken. Haste thee, escape thither, for I cannot do anything till thou be come thither. Therefore the name of the city was called Zoar. The sun was risen upon the earth when Lot entered into Zoar. Then the Lord rained upon Sodom and upon Gomorrah, brimstone and fire from the Lord out of heaven.
Yeah, yeah, which is what that sulfur, man. That sulfur. And funny enough, Russia got an ICBM called brimstone, right? But it said it rained upon it, meaning it came out of the sky, and that's literally how America's gonna be destroyed. But this time, the Lord is gonna put the spirit on these the world's armies to reenact that same event, right? Spiritually called Sodom and Egypt. Spiritually Sodom, because guess what? You're gonna receive the same judgment as Sodom. And how was it destroyed? From fire and brimstone out of heaven. That's how America's gonna be destroyed. So basically, we know from that scripture alone that the United States of America is on a path to destruction. In ancient Sodom, right, men just probably wore dress, acting off, right? You know, getting popped out and popping beasts, you know, like Pompeii, right?
Which that got burned with fire as well.
That got burned by fire, you know, ash, which was hot. Right, and it's crazy, you know, if you go into Pompeii, right, because I did a special on that. If you go into Pompeii, right, the ash was so hot, right, that it actually made people's blood actually boil, and it exploded their heads. The heads exploded. So now, if that was just from ash, how much more than missiles? If that was just the ash, it wasn't even like fire. The ash itself burned them, engulfed them. How much more? That's why you even got a guy who's having a wank while this is going on, and he's just stuck there like this.
Well, and that's what we joke about, like, what, you know, in the law, but you guy will see the missiles, like, fuck it, my uncle commit the adultery,
doing my last wickedness.
You know, and that's what you saw there, because you had people encased whilst doing homosexual acts and all of that.
Yeah, fucking beasts. You know, I believe if you go into the art in Pompeii, they said 80% of the art in that town was dicks. Yeah. They got dicks on the wall, dicks on the floor, dick statues and dildos. You know,
obsession with sex was much like this kingdom, man.
Yeah. What's the point that you always make when the kingdom's going down?
Oh yeah, there's seven stages to the kingdom. There's a documentary, 12 Horsemen on YouTube, where the first section of it goes on to the seven stages of the fall of the kingdom, right, and the last is the age of decadence.
Oh yeah, no, that was second before.
Yeah, Yeah, age of decadence, man. Decadence where there's an obsession with sex, man. Yeah. And you look at this kingdom, there's an obsession with sex, man. And everywhere you go, you know, you just have the lingerie, this lingerie. I mean, let's look at the way these women dress, man. Alright?
And it says,
Salah, four horsemen, my bad, Salah.
And it says, and he overthrew those cities, and all the plain, and all the inhabitants of the cities, and that which grew upon the ground. And if I can just read a little bit more on this article, just, you know, the scripture backs it up, man. It says, the research is right. The archaeological data collected from across the entire occupational footprint of Tel Haman, which where they say is modern, you know, ancient city, Sodom. It says, a directional pattern for the high heat explosive. It says, in an instant, devastated. It was an event that in an instant devastated approximately 500 kilometers squared immediately north of the Dead Sea, not only wiping out 100% of cities and towns, but also stripping agricultural soils from once fertile fields and covering Tel Haman with a superheated brine of Dead Sea and hydride salts pushed over the landscape by the event's frontal shockwave. And that lines up with the scripture. And I wanted to read a scripture to back it up as well, because it said, in an instant, right? Because the brother was bringing out America's modern day Sodom. And it says, 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3, when they shall say peace and safety, then sudden destruction cometh upon them as travail upon a woman with child, and they shall not escape. You know? And when their missiles get shot, man, it's going to be a quick thing, man. Mm. You know? It's going to be a quick thing, but America's going to be burning up for a very, very, very long time, man.
For a long time.
Yeah.
For a long time.
As in example, you know, in Peters, man.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. You know, it's... like, even if you... Like a... Hot water... In a small cup, it doesn't compare to, like, hot water in a bath. It's hot for a long time. Mm-hmm. So like, a small fire, it doesn't compare to a big, mass... Right, yeah. 3,000, you know, square miles, whatever, of fire.
That's right.
You know, got that Revelation 18.
Yeah.
And can you read that Peter's and then read the 18, and then we're gonna close up.
Second Peter chapter 2, and verse 6, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow.
He condemned it
into ashes.
That means God, you know, people like, you know, only God can judge me. Well, right, cool. God judged them. And how he judged, since someone might talk shit about us, or how you can't say that, only God can judge me, all of that, right? Yeah. Well, you would rather have us condemn you, so cool.
Yeah,
then the Most High condemned. When the Most High condemned, the Most High talk.
Yeah,
him just do.
Right, because we ain't got the power to right now to perform the judgment of the Lord. Oof.
Yeah.
It's a fearful thing to fall into the hand of living power.
Yeah, like you probably had freaks in paradise, man.
Yeah.
All of that, yeah.
It's usually that fast flipping techno music.
All of that. And fucking ecstasy.
Underground discos.
Then fucking
latex.
Yeah. And then fucking the fire got hotter.
Chokers.
Yeah. The chokers and you know them shoes are thick. You know. Platform shoes. You know, probably shaking, you know. Then he's all getting, you know. Oh, you know. And like one day the fire entered his yard, man. Mm-hmm. The fire gave him a knock on the door, man.
Yeah.
And it fool went to open it. Mm-hmm. When it opened it, he couldn't close it.
Mm-hmm.
You know. Go on.
It says, and turning the cities of Sodom and Gomorrah into ashes, condemn them with an overthrow, making them an example unto those that should live ungodly, and deliver just Lot, vexed with the filthy conversation of the wicked.
So he's vexed, man. He's vexed.
he was vexed with the filthy conversation with Wicked, and that spiritual applies unto us now.
Yeah, God.
Yeah, hey, because like it said in the Genesis story, where they saw the men come into the city, like, who are they? Well, so just like how you might see a girl check out a guy, that's how these freaks are checking out other men, man.
Yeah.
Right? And you see them all lost and like, oh my God, he's so cute. And you're like, what the fuck? Where are we?
In Babylon. That's where we are. Sodom, bro.
Just to show you that the adverse is that there's also a scripture that says they're vexed with the upright conversation of the righteous. Something along those lines. So it just shows you that we're at odds, man.
Mm.
You know, we hate the filthy conversation of the wicked, and they hate the righteous, upright conversation of the righteous, man.
Yeah, hey, that's what scripture's also saying, Isaiah, when you speak to Israel, speak unto me, speak unto smooth things, man.
Yeah.
Right, because when you speak right things, you're cutting them. Mm. Right, whereas people, what you call it, whereas people like the Bible's going into, right, when they don't want to hear or speak right things, because right things basically kills their fucking killjoy, aren't you?
Oh, they hate those that rebuke in front of the gate.
That's right.
God.
You have more on that up?
That's on that one. Do you want the
Revelation 18 and like 4
God.
And 18 and 11. I'm sure.
Revelation chapter 18 and verse 4. And I heard another voice from heaven saying, come out of her, my people, that ye be not partakers of her sins, and that ye receive not of her plagues.
Mm-hmm.
For her sins have reached unto heaven.
And that's what it said about Sodom,
mm-hmm.
Gomorrah, that their sins has come back before the Lord.
Mm-hmm.
Right? You know, go ahead.
And Yahweh have remembered her iniquities.
Yeah, cause meaning now he's chosen. There's going to be a time when he's going to be like, yeah, this is the time to destroy America. Guess what? It's spiritually Sodom, so it's going to receive the same judgment as Sodom.
God.
Go ahead.
Reward her even as she rewarded you,
mm-hmm.
and double unto her double according to her works.
Yeah, that's right. And when it says come up, it's talking about us being beamed up into them chariots, man. Right? Because the scripture says, only with thine eyes thou shalt see what? The reward of those who are wicked, man. Go ahead.
In the cup which she hath filled, fill it to her double.
Exactly, and that's what's going to happen. Skip to verse 11.
Verse 10. 10, standing afar off.
Yeah.
For the fear of her torment, saying, alas, alas, that great city Babylon.
Confusion.
That mighty city, for in 1 hour is thy judgment come.
Spiritually Sodom, in 1 hour is thy judgment come.
God.
Yeah, because Russia have fucking ICBM that can get to America in 50 minutes.
Right,
and they have ICBMs which can take like different routes whereby they actually can't shoot it down.
Well, you've also got what they in NATO, which America's a part of, have because basically Russia will have a weapon and Russians will call it one thing, but then NATO will have a different name, and designates, they give the name to their submarines as black holes because they can't fight, they can't see them. So you've probably got ICBM carrying nukes off the coast of America right now.
Yeah.
They don't know.
Yeah. But like, I'm sure, if I'm mistaken, there was like a aircraft or submarine that just flew past like Scotland. Russia's had a vehicle,
mm.
which just flew past England, like. No, Scotland, and then the military only found out like 2 weeks later, you know.
Yeah, stories about that a lot with the Russians and their hardware.
Yeah, man. Again, you got anything to say? Well, this place is going to be destroyed, man.
And rightfully so.
And rightfully so, man, because it's wickedness, man. You know, they push forth that spirit throughout the earth, and it's not right. You know, and the Lord, as you saw in Sodom and Gomorrah, right, don't like it, bro.
Mm-hmm.
You know, so that Lord say, oh, praise be. Double honest possible of the great most on the most.